Now, joke is another sweet construction. And you know, we said in one of the earlier episodes, the sweetness factor can be attributed largely to the Komal Gandhar, Komal Nishad combination. Most of the rags which use this combination sound very sweet. There's this sweetness in the melodic structure there. And joga has that structure. Joga is not a very ancient rag. It has added itself quite late in the evolution of the rag, probably about 300 years ago. Because there are it was sung in Drupad too, so it definitely came before the Khayal period. Joga has various versions, a couple of versions. One is the one which is coming from the Drupad, which is adopted by the Agra Gharana. And the other one, so I'll explain the differences here. There are two. One with the Shuddha Nishad, so it uses both the Nishads. So let us look at Jogas. So this Jog with both the Nishads comes out of Tilang. So they believed that it's an offshoot of Tilang. And what is Tilang? Tilang is this doesn't have the Komal Gandha. Sa ga ga ma ga ma pa ma ga ma ga sa. So there is no Komal Gandha. Ga ma pa ni pa, that is the Komal Nishad. And then ga ma pa ni ni, this is the Shuddha Nishad. Nisa, Nisa, Nipa, Mapa, Maga, Gama, Ga, Sa. So, this is Tilang. And the Jog was visualized as this Tilang with an addition of Komal Gandha. Sa ga ma ga ma ga ga sa. But then it maintained the Tilang structure in the Uttaragam. So this is the structure of Jog, which is still practiced by the Agra lineage. But then, in the last few decades, about 30-40 years, the Shuddha Nishad has been omitted in the structure. And this gives you the current version of Jog, the other popular version of Jog, which does not have the Shuddha Nishad. So, exactly the same structure, omitting the Shuddha Nishad. Sa ga ma ga ma ga sa ni pa ni sa. So only the Komal Nishad. Now if you closely look at this, what is actually happening is there is a shade of Malcolm's out here. Ga ni sa ga sa sa ga sa, which is broken by the use of Shuddha Gandhi. If I didn't have the Shuddha Gandha, this is Malcolm's. So this version of joke, which is the more popular and the more used version of the joke, uses only the Komal Nishad, and I think you see the shades of Malcolm's. So this is the current version of joke. So let us just go through joke now, note by note, and see how things look. So as we kept on saying, as an advancing listener, now we should try to look at the shapes of the Komal Swara used also. Look at the way the Gandhar is used and look at the Nishad Gandhar pairing. Spot there to make a joke. And then the Shuddha Gandhar comes, you know, in a stark contrast to this Komal Gandhar. You know, that is the if you listen to a live mahfil, this Shuddha Gandhar, you know, makes a very dramatic entry. You know, the artist would keep you around the Komal Gandhar for quite some time, and then, you know, the Shuddha Gandhar strikes like lightning there. Gandhar, Komal Gandhar comes from the ma and not, see. So one, you know, I think when we were talking about Lalit, we said that there is a rule for the construction of a ra, that if you have both the versions of a swara, then they will never come. They will never be used adjacent to each other. No? They will not follow each other. They'll in continuation. So this will not happen. And then the touch of pancham there. Gandhar always dramatic, the Shuddha Gandhar. And then comes the landing of the pancham. Gama, gama, pa, pa, ma, pa, ga. No, there has always been a debate whether what weighs more, the pancham or the madhya, the pa or the ma. And, you know, artists have used both as focal points and used it to develop the rag. Panini pa, this is the formal nisha. That shade of Malcolm's out there. This is Joe.